Hey friends, in the previous lecture, we have got to know that is what is the concept behind the hydrolysis, and in that case also we have got to know that is a particular solution can be turned into acid or base depending on the salt which is added in that particular water. So now let us talk about that is what is the effect of the hydrolysis of that is strong acid and weak base on the solution. So let us talk about it. So now we are adding a basically salt which is derived from a strong acid and a weak base, and that is the reason that we are taking an example, that is NH4Cl. So this is a salt which is because it is made up of that is a strong acid, I would call it as HCl, and a weak base that is NH4OH, and that is what it is made from. And suppose this is the salt that we are adding in water or for which a hydrolysis process that will happen. So therefore this is a good electrolyte because or we could call it as it is a strong electrolyte because it will dissociate completely into that is NH4 plus as well as the Cl minus ion. So that's the reason that we could write it over here as the ionized products are basically NH4 plus along with that of the Cl minus. And if it has been reacted with water, so but water is what we know, it is a very weak electrolyte, so therefore it will dissociate into that is H plus partially and the OH minus. But the main thing is if what happens if the NH4Cl is been reacted with that of water, and let us see that what happens. So it has been usually said that when NH4Cl is been reacted with water, and as we know that is it dissociates completely into NH4 plus and Cl minus, so when this will react with that of water, then it has been observed that that the NH4 plus it would be more capable of that is getting the OH minus, and that's the reason that the solution will form that is NH4OH rather than the Cl will combine with that of HCl, because HCl is itself supposed it forms. Obviously, it is a very strong electrolyte, so obviously it will dissociate, and that's the reason that there will be no kind of interaction between the Cl minus and this H plus, and that's the reason that we could see that there will be strong interaction of NH4 plus and that of the OH minus ion. So that would affect the concentration of the OH minus ion, and also can increase the concentration of H plus ion. So let us see how can there will be effect on this thing. So let us talk about it. So we have to make the hydrolysis of the salt, and obviously we have chosen a salt like that of the NH4Cl, and we know that the NH4Cl is the one that will dissociate into basically NH4 plus along with that of the Cl minus, and suppose that has been reacted with water, that is H2. So in this case basically we will get a product like NH4OH as we have discussed earlier also. So therefore NH4OH is the one that is the product that we would form. And along with that of the HCl that will be present in that of an ionic form only. So therefore that would dissociate into that is H plus and that of the Cl minus. So if we observe then we could see that the equilibrium is being maintained in this case. So the only thing that we have to do is we have to cancel out this Cl minus that is present in the right one, and this Cl minus that is present in the, so we have to cancel out the Cl. So that is what we have did over here. And if you observe, then the solution that it has basically it consists of basically NH4 plus, and that will react with that of the water molecule, and so as to produce basically a weak base that is nothing but NH4OH along with that of H plus. So if you observe that the salt that was reacted with H2, it forms a weak base that is NH4OH. And in that, we could get the concentration of H plus ion also. So in this case, basically, we could see that the water molecule that consists of H plus ion and OH minus ion, in that case, the OH minus is being utilized so as to form a weak base, while the concentration of H plus ion, it goes on increasing. Or we could say that comparatively, H plus ion concentration is comparatively more than that of the OH minus concentration. So if we compare it with the help of a pH scale, we'll get to know that is if the concentration of H plus ion goes on increasing, then pH value will go on decreasing. But the range is pH should be 7, then only it will be called as a neutral one. But this solution that we have got over here, it is not a neutral solution. So in this case, basically pH is more than compared to that of OH minus ion. So obviously we could say that the value of pH is less than 7, making this to be not to be neutral, not to be basic, but acidic solution. So this is how we can convert a particular like for water, which is basically neutral in nature. A pure water is neutral in nature, but by adding salt like NH4Cl, which is nothing but a salt which is derived from a that is a weak base and a strong acid. So that is what we can make, and we can make the solution to be more acidic. So that's it. I wanted to explain, and that's an example. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood the concept that how can we convert a particular solution to more acidic one, and by adding the salt. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.